Hi there, welcome to another video from Hegarty Maths. It's Mr. Hegarty here. We're talking about straight lines, and in particular we're talking about when they're parallel. So let's start with something you already know. Previously, we've learned how to draw graphs like this using the form y equals mx plus c. So could you just take a second to pause the video, double check you can draw those graphs on this pair of axes here using the ideas of the gradient and the y-intercept. Okay, you should have got the following. And what you would have done, say for this one, you know the gradient is 3, you know the y-intercept is 0.7, so starting at 0.7, every time you go across one, you go up 3. And similarly with the others. Now, why have I picked these particular lines? Well, they are all what we call parallel. And you can see that they're parallel because there's the same distance between them anywhere along the two lines. They're parallel there. They're never going to cross over or meet each other within a two-dimensional axis like that. And the other way you know they're parallel is that they've got, therefore, the same gradient. So because the gradient here, m, is 3, because the gradient here, m, is also 3, and because the gradient here, m, is 3, we call all of these lines parallel. They have the same gradient. So when we say parallel, we mean have same gradient. And that's the idea we're going to use in this particular video. So, straight on to an example. Pause the video and have a go if you think you can. Otherwise, I'll go through in a few seconds. Write down an equation of a line which passes through 2, 1 and is parallel to the line with equation y equals 2x add 3. So, what it's telling us is it wants us to find a line that is parallel to this. So it has the same gradient as this, but it passes through this point. Okay? Now, our line, we're going to call our line y equals mx plus c. Because we want it parallel to this, we're going to want m to be 2. So state that m is going to be 2, and we know a coordinate on our line is going to be 2, 1. So let's start by putting m as 2. So y equals 2x plus c. Now we're going to substitute in x is 2 and y is 1. So 1 is equal to 2 brackets 2 add c. 1 is therefore equal to 4 add c. Subtract 4 off both sides and we get c is negative 3. And therefore we can state the equation y is going to equal, well, we've got our c. We always had our m because it's the same gradient as the line that was given to us. So y is equal to 2x take away 3. And just before you go ahead, double check. It's certainly parallel to this line because it's got a 2 there. But check 2, 1 satisfies this line. If I put x is 2 in, 2 times 2 is 4. 4 take away 3 is 1. Yeah, 100% certain that is the right answer. Let's try another one. Pause the video, have a go. So we want to write down the equation of a line which passes through negative 2, 1 and is parallel to this one here. Now this line, I can rewrite it in the form y equals mx plus c as y is negative 2x add 3. Right, so our equation, let's state the equation of the line we're looking for is y equals mx plus c. We want it to be parallel to this line here, so we want our m to be negative 2, that's right, and we want it to go through the coordinates negative 2, 1. So substituting in m is negative 2 first, we can say y is negative 2x add c. Now we're going to substitute in the negative 2 and 1. So we're going to say, therefore, that 1 is equal to negative 2 multiplied by negative 2 add c. So 1 is going to equal 4 add c. Subtracting 4 off both sides, we're going to get c is negative 3. So we have our c, we always had our m, so we can state that y is therefore equal to negative 2x subtract 3. Before you go ahead, double check that this point lies on the line. If I substitute in x is equal to negative 2, do I get y is 1? Negative 2 times negative 2 is 4, 4 take away 3 is 1. Yep, that's right, and negative 2, that's parallel to this line, so I'm definitely right. Last one for us to try, a bit trickier. Pause the video, see if you can work that out yourself before I show you. Now write down the equation of a line which passes through this point here and is parallel to the line with this equation. Now we can't tell what the gradient is by looking at that straight off. We need to put it in the form y is equal to mx plus c. So we're going to need to do a bit of rearranging. So let's add 2x to both sides and take away 5 from both sides in order to isolate the y, or leave the y by itself on the left. Now currently we've got 3y, so this would give us 3y would equal 2x subtract 5. Remember, we want y on its own, so we need to divide everything through by 3, and we'd get ourselves y is therefore 2 divided by 3, I'll write as 2/3 x, subtract 5 divided by 3, I'll write like that. Now, that rearrangement has only told us about this line here, but it's told us that the gradient is 2/3, so that's the gradient we want for our new line. So our new line is y equals mx plus c, and we know now that m is supposed to be 2/3, and a point on the line is negative 3, 2. So substituting in m is 2/3, y is 2/3 x add c. Now we're going to substitute in the negative 3 and 2, which we want on this line. So we're going to say, therefore, that 2 is equal to 2/3 multiplied by negative 3 add c. 2/3 times 3 is 2, so 2/3 times negative 3 is negative 2. So 2 equals negative 2 add c. Add 2 to both sides, I get c is 4. So at last I've got my c, I have my m, so I can say that y is therefore equal to 2/3 x add 4. Now before you launch ahead, double check that x is negative 3 and y is 2 lies on the line. If I put negative 3 in here, 2/3 times negative 3 is going to equal negative 2. Negative 2 add 4 is going to give me positive 2, and I'm done. And that's it for this particular skill. Thanks for watching.